Truth is what is. But if you are concerned with a lie, what should be, and what should be is a fantasy, a terrible, terrible lie that someone gave the people long ago.
You know, it's kind of depressing, but the truth is the truth, whether we like it or we don't like it. But is there something more important than the truth? I made all the wrong choices. I mean, I've actualized nothing. I've accomplished nothing. I mean, I've just spent 47 years banging my head against the wall. And I had it all. I mean, it, you know, in a sense. I mean, I had every opportunity to be somebody, and I just allowed myself to be nobody. And well, I don't even know allowed. It's not even the right word. It's just like I couldn't find a strategy. I couldn't find a way to get around all the crap I had to get around to get anywhere. To find some sort of future that would fit into the normal context of definition of success. But in a strange way, at 22, I would have looked at my life, I would have looked at what I am, and I said, Jesus, what an asshole. But, you know, reflecting on it, I can't say it was a failure just because I'm satisfied with who I am. And that's kind of the best feeling there is.
To seem wacky. And so I guess that's where you have to go to is the, like, why did I never find the story compelling or believable? And it's like the Santa Claus story. I mean, I never believed there was a Santa Claus. I mean, it's just, you're told this story and you kind of just know they're lying to you. You just know, it's just too crazy because they can't answer any of the questions. You know, the, well, then why does, and we don't even have a chimney, so how does, you know, and you don't get any good answers. Or you get some kind of silly answer like magic powers or whatever. And that just never fit in my head. I mean, you have to explain magic powers. You have to justify them somehow. I mean, Superman's more believable than Santa Claus, you know. And, or for that matter, God. And part of it was, you know, there was just nothing about religion that was appealing. I mean, nothing about how they defined God, how they described what God was about, that was at all interesting. I mean, God didn't seem to give a damn, number one. I mean, he wasn't playing any active role. You're told this story about these people that lived way the fuck over there in some desert. You know, the same people that people are calling all kinds of ugly names. That's the sacred people of your God, you know, the religion they're trying to preach to you. And it's like, well, I mean, if those are the chosen ones, how come you're talking shit about them? You know, so, I mean, even that, that little hypocrisy, I remember that meaning something to me at a very young age.
Reproduction, cannibalism, and addiction. So he concedes that that's basically what life is made out of. Okay, it's just molecular chemistry. That's just doing this, you know, acquire the parts, produce another copy, produce it in a finite environment, so then the parts have to be stolen from other owners. Which is the cannibalism. And then when you get into a psychology, you get the brain thing. The brain thing just gets completely motivated to do these three things, and it does it through being addicted to sources of that. Addicted to food every day and, sex and whatnot. And that's our psychology. It's an addictive psychology. We're made deprivated. We're made to feel empty or alone or lacking. And therefore, we will pursue what the DNA agenda demands. And so he's conceding that that's the mechanism. It's basically, he's conceded it's a Frankenstein monster, and that's where he sort of left it. And then he's going to argue, I don't think there's any ambiguity about my opinion. If there was no human life on planet Earth, yeah, the button gets pressed without even a thought. I mean, I don't even have to give it a millisecond of thought. It's insidious. Any idiot who would leave the experiment running would have to be just that, an idiot. Okay, it's just animals trapped on an island consuming each other. You wouldn't let your cousins be trapped on an island where they eat each other. And yeah, that's what animals are doing, and it's disgusting and horrible, and it's pointless, and they're not accomplishing anything, and they're not going to do anything but do that, and it's just it's idiotic. Anybody who justifies it is stupid. All right, but by taking care of them, by protecting them, by honoring their claim to the future, by honoring their claim to assets that don't exist, by attempting to honor that claim, we are going to kill perhaps millions of human beings. That's how fucking, and you wonder why I'm a little angry, and I'm pissed off, and I'm intolerant, and I have no patience for this conversation. This is like you're standing on a goddamn top of a hill, and on one side of the hill are a huge number of starving people. On the other side of the hill is a huge wheat field. And somehow these assholes, you can't convince these assholes that all they have to do is walk up the fucking hill. Walk up the fucking hill. There's a whole bunch of food over there. No, they're just gonna sit there and starve to fucking death. All right? Because they, why? Because they you know, they have some taboo.
No, that's the taboo, no. It's like Planet of the Apes, you put little stick figures or something. And no, that's the fence. And you came across as the theoretical fence. We've got to protect the rich. The rich are what makes our lives possible. We can't have a life without the rich. The owners, we must have the owners. I mean, it's just so
fucking goddamn stupid. And so that's why, yeah, I have no patience. I'm so frustrated that I have to waste time arguing with you about the stupid fractional reserve banking when it has nothing to do with the problem. All right? Because all of that fractional reserve banking crap was all secured loans. It was all collateralized. It was all legitimate claims on stuff that actually exists now. Houses and shit. Okay? It wasn't on claims on the future. And I agree with you on the national debt stuff. I mean, the government borrowing money is really dumb. But the government, if the government had printed $13 trillion, the dollar wouldn't be worth anything.
All right, introduction video for a new channel. Suffering sucks. Guess what the subject is? Yeah, suffering sucks, and there's ways that we can do something about that reality, and, you know, whether it's, you know, being responsible in our interaction with animals, trying not to eat them if we don't have to, trying not to at least torment and torture them if we don't have to, but certainly even in humans, we could treat humans a lot better. It's just part of our reality here. Certainly there's other people that, have, you know, there's organizations that are attempting to do something to look after the welfare of animals. But it all does get kind of complicated. The existence isn't free. Whether we personally pay the price or not is kind of irrelevant. The price is being paid. Living things suffer. We suffer. And that's the objective's got to be to reduce the amount of that suffering. It seems so logical that it shouldn't require explanation.
You don't care whether it's ethical. You don't care whether it can be done ethically and responsibly. You just don't want it to be done. All right? It's that clear. Because you're sadistic. You're selfish. You're so obsessed with your own life. And living your own life, but you can't even, you know, this guy laughs.
Through all kinds of parts of this video, he's chuckling. Let's see if we can hit some of the chuckles. And it's like, what the fuck is that about? So when you think about the patience of Dr. Kevorkian,
that makes you chuckle. I don't think it's, you know, Lou Gehrig's disease is nothing to fucking chuckle about. Chuckles.
We've got to make rational judgments. We can hate people, we can dislike people, and we should do it based on how efficient they are as human beings, based on how much they consume versus how much they produce. What's their qualitative impact on the whole, on all of consciousness as it exists and as it will exist in the future? Because that's where the ball game is, the future. And we're going to be players in it, even though we're dead. Consciousness is going to be a player. And that's the same thing as a you or a me. It's not going to, there's still going to be you and me out there, yous and me's. And it's just a delusion to think that if you get through this life privileged and comfortable, but you leave the world a shithole, that you've done yourself any favors, because you haven't. That consciousness will live, and it will be just as real as your life. So you haven't won anything.